usually beginning of afternoon is the worst moment for talking, but really you find the way of keeping everybody awake, and it was certainly the opportunity for everybody to answer all your questions, which were under the axioms, because I'm sure that even if you say that there are axioms, we could also say that it is hypothesis. If we think that, in a sense, we need to have pedagogues who are able to explain all that before every kind of audience, and telling them you have to be twice more critical than you were previously with all the tools that you had in your hands. In the only example which I know, which is Jonas, I see how difficult it is for people who are working every day on these databases, instead of writing articles and reviews and so on, because it is their job, and now they are just paid for that, and they can't do anything else, instead of leaving the MHT and going elsewhere. But I also know that they have the feeling that it is always a work in progress. And for example, in the example you mentioned about this manuscript of the Bibliothèque Nationale, I'm not sure of what I'm saying, but I think that is right. They worked mainly on some parts of the files in order to make a critical revision of the files. And this has been done for hagiography. And there you have checked information for this part of Jonas. But for all the other parts of the database, they just started to work by copying what had been written in the old files, written on sheets of paper in the section Romane. And for the new bibliography, what they did was to use young scholars in order to know what is a bibliography. And so every time when these young people saw such and such chef mark, they thought, well, it is very important for me to put that on the bibliography, because if I don't do that, they will tell me that I'm not clever enough and I forgot such and such reference. So this is another problem. It's very difficult to integrate young people to this work of spoiling bibliography, because they are not critical in their choice. And then I would say what is more terrible in the sense that you started to show is that now, since, like for the DEAF, we are in a hurry, we are obliged to go quicker than previously with this database of Jonas, they have decided to put the rest of the information on all the other documents of this database, all the information, even without checking anything. So it will be worse in the future. Sorry. And to add to the problem, we have another obligation, which is to translate the initial information in English, because, you know, French is no more a language for scholars. So they have to put money also, we have to put money also for translating in English all this wrong information. So, so questions, please? Yes, first. Okay, first thing.
When I invited to the chat, I told him, please be problematic, but I didn't.
I think it's very useful, your picture and your critical picture. I would like to stress two points. The first is something that we said also before, that is that we need authority. The wiki model is not a model that can work well, unfortunately perhaps, but authority in the sense of responsibility of what we put inside. So it's perhaps you skip going, you've been a little bit taken by your mechanism of getting books, but at the beginning you said that Frank Van Meulen, anyway, had put what should be put in the database. He is almost, he alone has built this database of the dead. He has his parameters, these parameters. It is a problem of who signs it. He signed it, that's good. So I would like to change the perspective and to see one of your negative axioms as a preoccupation for doing better.
But all my axioms, of course, have a very positive side, if you look at it from the other side.
Yeah. My second point is the crucial point for our databases on manuscripts. So that is the difference and the need that we have to preserve this difference, because what is written in the manuscripts and what is our interpretation of what is written. That is, you are interested in Fabio, you would like to write Fabio and have answers about manuscripts, but you want to have answer of what people say that is a Fabio in manuscripts, or you want to have answer on what the manuscript says is a Fabio. I can assure that there are databases, we do our databases in this way, where the two are inside, the two information are inside. What is, if the text in the manuscript is called Fabio,
we work on Italian literature, so
canzone, and what the on the contrary is not said in the manuscript, but you know that is a canzone. So you can do that a bit better, but you can do that in order to have answers to your question.
Of course, I should have mentioned earlier that we do are doing a database on Fabio manuscripts, and that's the way we are doing.
Well, thank you, Richard, for that presentation. And if no one invites you in the future, I will. Indeed, only because you really demonstrated the incestuous nature of portal and database-based knowledge representation. My question to you is, this all was very critical and to the point, but how could we overcome this, and how would we actually stimulate original thinking on the web?
Yes, well.
I think there's no secret. If we want to overcome what you call, I think I'm quoting you correctly, incestuous nature of the whole thing, of course there's only one way to do so. We have to go back either to the manuscript or at least to the authoritative critical study. So if we want to, and then take it from there, so if we want to create some scholarly input, that would be the starting point. Now, given the amount of information we are already dealing with and we are trying to cope with, of course it's a monumental task. But if we say today, well, it can't be done, or let's start by compiling for the next 3 years everything that's already there, create metamotors for what? You know, they will be stirring up the same dirt. There's nothing to do. If we can't improve the quality of what we are stirring up, there's no, in my opinion, there's not much point stirring up anything at all.
It is true that many information databases is anonymous, has no name of author. That is true because of various reasons. Partly because most of the information we have now in databases has been collected from existing sources, card files, inventories, anonymous and non-anonymous. That's institutions like IHT, bibliographic institutions, which made work available anonymously, was transferred into databases and to remain anonymously. On the other hand, let's say, when it goes about the descriptions of manuscripts, they do not necessarily have to be anonymous. Instead, those who do who make the descriptions are entitled to have the name added to it. So a good database should have a field in which the author, the Urheber, the one who has the right to it, who has to be blamed or to be praised for it, should be inserted in the database at any place in which it is relevant. That is very important. And then the question is, you also made a sort of implicit comparison between a monograph and a database. Well, a monograph is always signed, it has an author, it has a year, it has a date of publication, and it can be refuted or approved as it is, which is definitely not the case with a database, which is, as you said rightly, it is more often than not a work in progress. So it can be criticized, but it can also be corrected, whereas a printed monograph cannot. And you all know who deal with maintaining databases and correcting databases is difficult for various reasons. But it can be done. It is a principle, it is a characteristic of a database that it can be corrected. But it has to be done, and it's difficult to work. I said that too in my conference this morning. But it can be done, whereas a monograph cannot. I say a monograph can be, if it is not a good one, it can be forgotten. And after 10 years, no other scholar will refer to it. But for a database which should live longer than 10 years, for better or for worse, we have to refer to it. But it can be corrected. So the comparison between the two media is relevant, and it is good, and it helps us to think about the questions, but the differences between the two media are relevant as well.